Assalamualaikum and welcome to Jan Sewing Solutions. There was a question posed on the forum with regards to sewing fabrics, cotton fabrics or lawn fabrics, which are thin and transparent and see-through, and what needs to be done to those clothes to make them wearable. Now, there is this is a very, very difficult question in regards to when you are wearing very pure cotton fabrics, and then you need to line these, and how do you go about lining them, or what type of lining to use with those fabrics. Here in the UK, I often sew clothes of cotton and lightweight fabrics that are see-through, and we often line these with chiffon fabric like this. This is a dupatta fabric, and obviously the fabric, this cotton fabric, is not so transparent, but it is lightweight and it is, you know, see-through. There's a couple of reasons why we tend to line fabrics like this. One, it does give them a better drop, but secondly, because it's got embroidery and it's slightly irritable, the embroidery, we've lined this, but it really defeats the purpose of lining the cotton with a synthetic fabric of viscose based, elements in the fabric. Now, cotton is obviously breathable and it's good for hot weather or cold weather, but when you line it with synthetic fiber, then the fabric cannot breathe and it really kills off the purpose of wearing the cotton in the first place. And it's wearing two layers as well. So how do you go about lining fabrics of this nature when you are in warm, hot countries where you want the natural feel of the cotton next to your skin and you don't want the synthetics, because obviously, you know, that's not the reason why you're wearing them. Now, when I lived in Pakistan many years ago, I noticed that many of the women there, they tended to wear the lawn. And you know what? Nobody paid a secondary glance, and everybody wore the same. Everybody wore, and one of the most horrific things about wearing lawn is the fact that it clings to you and it's stuck to you. So every time you'll see the women wearing this, and when they stand up, it's all like crunched up, and especially when it was fashion of short kameez, you know, you could almost see the back of their salwar revealing. And that, to me, going from the UK and watching women wear that type of clothing, it sort of set me thinking, you know. But because everybody was wearing it, you sort of, you know, accepted it. And personally, I wasn't happy wearing that, and I would often wear something else with it. And you know, you have your own mindset of how you want to dress. But if I was, there's a couple of things that I've introduced and I've always suggested. So first and foremost, one of the things that I suggested was on lightweight fabrics, which actually tend to curl up or roll up, especially the very pure lawn type, the best thing to do with that type of clothing is add borders and trims or a heavy lace that will make it drop towards the bottom. Secondly, if you are going to line the kameez, then the best way to line a kameez of that nature for hot countries is a voile chemise, a cotton chemise in a lightweight fabric. And what you want to do with that cotton chemise is make it so that the part that you sweat the most and you feel the hottest is around the armhole area, armpits. So when you line your kameez, first of all, make sure to make the armholes fairly large. So don't make it overly fitted. Make it loose fitting garment, especially for hot weathers. And kurtas are absolutely brilliant for hot weathers because they're a lot more open. So galidar kurta is your first and foremost suggestion for hot weathers. On lawn, especially lawn fabrics. Secondly, make the armhole slightly large, and so that it's not stuck to you, and you are, you know, more free flowing. Free flowing garments are essential for hot countries. When you make a chemise with that garment, make the armhole of the chemise deeper than the armhole of the chemise, and don't sew it together, but sew it separately, but then make it like the strap type, and attach it on the shoulders and attach it on the sides, and don't make it that lengthy. Then when you make it a little bit shorter, attach it up to there. I will make one of these dresses and I will actually fully go through the tutorial. This is a simple explanation. Preferably make it round and add a heavyish border to the undergarment so that that doesn't curl up, and that has a drop as well. And what that will, even though your fabric will be see-through, you will not actually see the body parts, but you will see the chemise part of the garment, and it will, one, it will look attractive, and two, it will serve the purpose of what you're wearing it, and also present stop you from being if you're conscious, then it will take away that consciousness, and it will look stylish at the same time. Obviously you don't want to be overly hot. You don't need to line the sleeves and so on. All you need to, the most embarrassing part of wearing thin garments is actually showing the bra straps or the undergarment or the shape of the bust line. So really that portion of the body is what we're trying to protect, and to protect that part of the body, I can understand in hot countries where you are confined to what kind of garment you're wearing, and you don't want to be wearing overly thick garments, and at the same time you want to be modest and cautious of what you are wearing. So I might have repeated myself. I think my mind is going a little bit ballistic here. I'm getting my words a little bit mixed up, but what I'm trying to explain is that if you need to line your lawn fabrics, by all means line them, but line them carefully, line them wisely, and use the advice that I'm offering, really. This is just a little bit of my personal experience that I'm sharing. I know some of the members who are Western and who are unfamiliar with wearing this type of garments, they will find the tips very useful. If somebody who lives in predominantly, obviously we live in the West and we have different requirements to those that live in hot countries, what their requirements are, I would love to hear from anyone from the hot countries giving some sound advice on how they would tackle this problem. Do you just overlook it, and do you just go by doing the same old thing that's been happening for generations, or have you found a way or a method that is different? I would love to hear from you. Share your tips and your advice, because obviously if you share it with me, I will go on to share it with the masses. I value the customers and the members and the viewers advice, and I will take it on board and perhaps do a video of your replies in the future. So I would like to hear from all my viewers who are in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, Qatar. I know I have lots of viewers in Dubai and all over the world, so I would like to hear from the viewers who are there on how they tackle problems with wearing, what kind of clothing they wear, and how they go on to protect and stop the fabrics clinging to you, how you go on about lining suits like this. So sound advice is what we want. Love to hear from you all, and have a wonderful day.